Well, Lauren, as someone who's just come into the England squad, this is all pretty exciting, isn't it?
Yeah, very much so. It's exciting for obviously myself, a new member of the squad, and for the team moving forward as well. Competition's obviously hot for places at the minute, which is creating a really good competitive environment, and yeah, it's really exciting at the minute, yeah.
You got involved in the England squad a couple of weeks ago. How was that for the Pakistan series?
Yeah, it was nice. I think playing the Pakistan was kind of a nice integration into international cricket. And then obviously moving on to the Ashes, it's going to hotten up from there. But no, it was good. I enjoyed every minute of it.
And in terms of like the sort of step up from the level that you played before, could you notice a difference?
Yeah, I think the environments are similar. Like the England Academy obviously try and create an environment very similar to England. But I think obviously the pressure's greater. You're playing for your place more at England level. So in that respect, it is a jump up.
How did you feel when you got the news you were going to be involved in this Ashes series?
Yeah, I was thrilled. I think 6 months ago I didn't think I would be getting a call to say I'd be playing in the Ashes team, having only just got selected for the academy. So it's been a quick transition, but one that I'm really enjoying.
Are you surprised that things have kind of moved so quick for you?
I've always known that if I'm putting in the performances, you know, scoring regular runs, then I'm always in with a shout and you're staking your claim all the time. So I guess I'd always hope that scoring the volumes of runs that I've tried to score this year would put myself in the frame. And thankfully, that's what's happened.
For any cricketer, being involved in an Ashes is a massive thing. I mean, what does it mean to you?
Yeah, hugely. I think it's a pinnacle for men and women, and it's no different for us. Playing, you know, the Aussies number one in the world really is... the height of anyone's career, really.
What about sort of Ashes memories that you might have, you know, from a, you know, maybe a youngster watching the game, you know, boys and girls, you know, what are your memories looking back?
Yeah, I mean, it's always something that I've heavily supported. You know, it really is the pinnacle. An old hero of mine, Alex Stewart, you know, playing all those years back is always something that I've aspired and wanted to do. So to be part of it is just fantastic. Growing up, I always kind of looked up to him. He was a bit of a hero of mine, batting and wicket-keeping as well. I guess he's kind of what I wanted to do, really, having kept and batted all my life. He's a natural hero of mine, really.
You've already had a look at the Australia team. You played for the academy against Australia last week, and you made 74 at the top of the innings. So you must feel in pretty good nick.
Yeah, I'm feeling confident at the crease. It was a massive thing to play against number one in the world for a start, and it was obviously sets me up nicely for the Ashes, having faced all their bowlers just the other day. So yeah, I'm feeling confident, and it was nice to have a look at, you know, what they've got to offer, and nice to make some runs. So I'm feeling confident going into the Ashes test.
What was your mindset going into that game? Were you thinking actually if you made some runs, then it kind of pushes your name further forward in the selectors' thoughts?
Yeah, I mean, you can never play thinking about selection. You know, I was just kind of complete blank canvas, you know, ball by ball, see what they've got, not trying to think not too much about who's bowling at me, just, you know, playing the ball as it comes. And I think that's what led for me to being successful. But I think the less you think about the big occasion, you know, and just to keep things simple, the more successful it makes you, really.
You had a look at the Australian team. What did you think of them?
Yeah, obviously Perry's like a threat with the ball. First up, there's a fair bit of pace behind her and shapes it away nicely. And Scott's the same, you know, in-swing bowler. So they've got threatening bowling attacks. And again, with the batting, you know, Lanning really strikes the ball hard early, looks to play her shots, which is always a challenge for bowlers bowling at her because you know she's going to bring the attack to you. But I think. You know, if even for the academy, we were never out of our depth. We competed, and you know, we can impose a threat on them as well. So I think it's a really exciting time for the Ashes coming up now.
I'm not sure when you find out when the squad or the side actually gets announced, but what would it mean to you if you actually got the nod to play on Sunday?
Yeah, I mean, it would mean everything. It is like a childhood dream, playing in an Ashes series. Obviously, you know, you could only do what you can do in the games that you've played and then hope that's enough and it gets you selected. But like I said, competition's very hot for places at the minute, and just being part of it is a huge honour anyway.